Master Satil, I stopped Lord Fulminus. He created a madness-inducing plague to turn this planet's inhabitants against each other. If he'd succeeded, Voss would have exploded into mindless violence. The entire planet would be a slaughterhouse.
The brutality of the Sith knows no bounds.
I applaud you for a job well done. I know it wasn't easy dealing with the Voss people.
The Voss are strange, but in the end, I needed their help to win.
It shows true strength to admit to needing help from others. I hope strength enough for what I must ask of you. One of our missing Jedi has resurfaced, and the news isn't good. Warren Sidoru has attacked and boarded the Republic flagship Valiant.
What is Warren after?
The Valiant is commanded by Admiral Dabrin, one of our top military leaders. He's inflicted heavy casualties on Imperial forces. Admiral Dabrin possesses complete knowledge of the Republic's war plans. If the Imperial military gains that information, they'll crush us.
You're missing the point. The fallen Jedi serves the Emperor's agenda. We must learn his mission.
We have plenty of reasons to pursue this. Where are we headed, Master Satil?
The Valiant is drifting out of control at these coordinates. Liberate it, save the Admiral, and learn the Emperor's plans. Hurry. The Valiant's crew can't hold out much longer.
Another step, and the Admiral dies.
What happens to me doesn't matter. He's going to destroy us all. Kill him!
How can he destroy us all? It's only one ship.
He did something to my mind. Made me reveal the security codes for our entire fleet.
This flagship belongs to the Empire. Stay, and the Admiral's blood will be on your hands.
Is this what the Sith Empire has come to? Using old men as shields? I expected better, Warren.
I've killed more than 50 Sith in my time. I'll kill just as many Jedi before I'm done. Youth won't save you. My master gave me all the strength I need to finish this. A slave. With your power, you could do, be anything. You could rule worlds, crush all enemies, have any woman you want.
All I'd have to do is become the Emperor's puppet. Like you.
You don't understand. The dark side will set you free. I've tasted real power. I'll never return to the Jedi. This war is nearly over. Master Braga will lead the Empire to victory on Corellia. Billions will die.
The Emperor doesn't care about the war. He wants to destroy the galaxy, and you with it.
I wonder if Braga knows that. Doesn't matter. Let it all burn.
The knowledge in this man's head could destroy the Republic. He's a traitor. We can't let him live.
We have no time to waste. Be done with this.
We can't risk him escaping and telling the enemy what he knows. There's only one way to be sure that doesn't happen.
We will not kill a defenseless man. He was our ally once. I hope he will be again. Lock him up until other Jedi come to claim him. Understood, Admiral?
Weak as ever. This is why the Republic always fails.
I'll keep this traitor aboard on my terms.
The ship's medtechs will sedate him until your people arrive. If this information about Corellia is true, our forces are in danger. We'd better mobilize everything we have. I'll alert High Command. You inform your council. Good luck.
Admiral Dabrin and his flagship are safe, Master. We also captured Warren alive, but you'll find he's changed.
We were able to help Leha Nerez. We'll find a way to help Warren.
Warren revealed Master Braga is on Corellia. He's the Emperor's secret weapon in the war there.
The Republic is sending everything it has to liberate Corellia. If Master Braga is aiding the enemy...
The Emperor has no interest in keeping Corellia. He desires the deaths of billions to fuel his ritual.
Find Master Braga and stop this madness. Set course for Corellia immediately.
Master Jedi, I'm aware that my recent military record might raise some concerns. I want to reassure you that my squad fatality rates have not consistently been this high.
Nothing matters but the success of the mission, Sergeant.
Exactly, Master Jedi. The first squad I commanded after making Sergeant was sent to free POWs being held at a small Imperial outpost. Intel said the place would be lightly manned. Most of the Imperials wouldn't arrive for another 24 hours. Intel was wrong.
The outpost wasn't lightly manned, or the POWs weren't being held there?
The Imperials sent their reinforcements a day early. When my squad broke into the outpost, we were outnumbered 10 to 1. We were outmanned and outgunned, but we achieved our objective, freed all the POWs, and came out alive. My squad's casualty rate was 97.4%, but we had no fatalities.
It's impressive that anyone made it out of there with those odds.
They were good soldiers. Far better than any of the others I've had under my command. Our mission was accomplished without permanent loss of Republic resources. That squad was effectively trained, and as a result, we achieved victory much more efficiently.
They must have been remarkable soldiers.
They are. Good soldiers are a resource. Yes, their loss damages the war effort, but they are meant to be used. Victory for the Republic is worth any cost. Master Jedi, our downtime has had a positive impact on my battle readiness. I believe I'm 14.2% more prepared for combat now.
It's good to know you've been using your time wisely, Sergeant.
I've had a lot of time to think. I've forgotten what that was like.
Relax while you can, Sergeant. There's more fighting ahead.
I'm looking forward to it. I've been thinking about my original squad. I haven't seen any of them since we liberated that POW camp. They seem to be on active duty, but I can't find any mention of commendations or recognition. They should be decorated soldiers.
I'm sure you'll find something.
Carson, Naja, Eckard, that whole squad has simply vanished.
They're probably just posted somewhere far from the fighting.
It seems like a terrible waste of skilled personnel. They'd be most valuable to the Republic deployed on the front. This just doesn't make sense to me. Finally tracked down my old squad mates, Master Jedi. Wishing I hadn't. General Garza recruited them into the Special Forces Black Ops program. But now, they're in a detention facility on Beirun, convicted of war crimes.
Black Ops are supposed to be secret. Who gave you this information?
It started as a nasty rumor from Imperial propaganda, but the detention center's warden confirmed everything. They renamed my old squad the Surgeons, tasked them with destabilizing the Empire's command structure by removing its best leaders. But the Surgeons didn't just target Imperial commanders. They went after the officers' families. They wanted to send the enemy a message.
I wouldn't put it past the Empire to frame your old squad.
I wondered the same thing, but the fact is, they all confessed. They're proud of what they did. The detention center's warden says my old squad mates are serving life sentences. They're young. That's a lot of years to spend in cages. The next time I get nostalgic and curious, Master Jedi, give me a planet to invade. My old squad mates were good soldiers when I knew them. Still can't believe how they ended up. If I hadn't been reassigned after that first mission, I might have been one of them.
You wouldn't have endured innocent blood on your hands. You're not like them, Sergeant.
No, I'm not. It's a far greater honor to be assigned to your squad, Master Jedi. I look forward to the day we face the Emperor together. I've been analyzing your battle tactics, Master Jedi. I hope you don't mind. I believe I've found a way to increase my own combat efficiency by another 25.4%.
Why don't we try out your new tactics in the field?
I was hoping you'd say that, Master Jedi. Permission to speak freely, Master Jedi.
Proceed, Sergeant.
Thank you. I had some concerns when I was first assigned to your squad. The Jedi are known for their discipline and selflessness, and for their pacifist philosophies. I'm pleased to say my concerns were unfounded.
After Hoth, I'm not sure why you would have thought I was a pacifist.
As I said, my concerns were unfounded. I came from a pacifist colony, Master Jedi. We were bullied, remorselessly, by pirates, corporations, huts, even governments. I joined the military as soon as I could. Peace only comes to those willing to fight for it.
I'm sure your family is glad you're defending them, even if you disagree with their ideals.
10 years ago, the colony was attacked by the Sith. My family was killed. They never fought back. The Sith crushed them, the way you might step on a bug.
They died for their principles. That's as honorable a death as one can achieve. Not everyone has such courage.
Courage? Honor? Perhaps. At any rate, we should move on. Thank you for hearing me out.
I can't believe this. Standards at the Republic Health Administration must be non-existent. I went to medical school with a new acting head.
Guy is a moron. Doesn't know a vibro scalpel from a field cauterizer. Barely passed his final exams. How is he the top doctor in the Republic?
It's been a while since you were in school together. His skills must have improved.
The only thing that improved was his bank account. Now he's going to be in all the medical journals. This is what always happens. Real doctors go out and save lives. Idiots stay on Coruscant and get themselves promoted. So what if this guy invented a vaccine for Zabrak scalp necrosis? I could have done it. I'm just busy.
What is Zabrak scalp necrosis? Sounds bad.
Oh, it's just a low-grade flesh-eating virus. Makes Zabrak's horns fall out. Embarrassing, not life-threatening. Tell you this much. Enough's enough. No more Mr. Nice Doc. The galaxy's gonna find out what a real physician looks like. I gotta find a disease to cure. Something really unpleasant. Old Doc's always been more of a lover than a fighter. But I had to up my game since you came around. It's not easy looking good when you're fighting next to a Jedi. But I figured out the trick.
Care to clue me in before our next big battle?
Let's just say I'm getting a new nickname. Dr. Knockout. Yep. Next time we're surrounded by the scum of the galaxy, they're gonna be sorry they met me.
I don't believe this! We missed the party of the Millennium last night. It's all over the holonet. Music, dancing, attractive people. We could have been a part of it if we hadn't been on the wrong side of the galaxy, saving everyone's lives as usual. two heroes of the Republic, would have been colossal at that shindig. Infinite opportunities for romance. We would have had it made.
What you mean is, you would have had it made. I would have been stuck keeping you out of trouble.
If that trouble was 1.6 meters tall, with green eyes and red hair, I'd have let you off the hook. I'm in the prime of my life, and I'm spending it with people who enjoy running around on exploding planets. All I want is to abuse our fame just for one night. Is that so wrong? It shouldn't be this hard to find a terrible disease I can cure. All the good ones are taken. All that's left are embarrassing things like Both and Nether Rot or diseases that'll take decades to treat. I don't have that kind of time.
There's bound to be something you can cure. Does it have to be a major disease? There are plenty of uncommon ones.
You don't understand how medicine works. If no one knows it's a disease, they don't care if you cure it. This won't keep me down. I'll cure an important disease even if I have to create it myself. Say, that's not a bad idea.
The galaxy doesn't need any new diseases, Doc.
What's the harm? I'd cure it right away.
I'm glad you stopped by, but old Doc has thinking to do. You should go meditate. Clean your lightsaber and whatever. Old Doc's luck is finally turning around. Got a holocall from this ravishing Ratataki I knew on Hutta. Big opportunity to cure something important.
Is this woman another broken-hearted lover you jilted along the way?
She wishes. We were like two ships passing in the hyperlanes. Never thought I'd hear from her again. My friend's old employer is a Hutt cartel boss named Nemro. He's infected with an incurable disease. It's eating him alive. Literally. No one's ever cured what Nemro has. He'll pay top credits to any doctor who can save his life. This is my big chance.
Do you actually have a plan to fight this disease?
Turns out, I studied this disease back in medical school. There's an experimental treatment no one's ever been able to try. It's too risky.
I figure if there's a safe place to work with toxic chemicals, it's a Jedi starship. I know you don't mind.
Just tell me you know what you're doing.
After all this time, doesn't that go without saying? Besides, I started mixing the solution hours ago and the ship's still intact. Now, give old Doc room to work. I got a date with medical history. The treatment formula's ready. Good thing. Nemro's half the height he used to be. My friend's on her way to help. How's my hair? These clothes fit all right? Old Doc's gotta look his best for the historical record.
Worry about your appearance after you've cured Nemro.
By then it'll be too late. When I save Nemro's life, the hollow journalists will be all over me. Oh, here she comes. Look at you, gorgeous. Love the new tattoo, huh? Nice gun.
Let's get this over with. I don't enjoy playing hostage. Not for you, anyway.
I need to make sure Nemro doesn't try to keep me all to himself after I cure him. Hutts occasionally confuse gratitude with kidnapping. Nemro's got a soft spot for my friend. I'm paying her to stay here as my hostage while I fly to Hutta. Brilliant, huh?
If you're worried about Nemro, take me with you. This hostage scheme is ridiculous.
Jedi don't have clearance to land on Hutta. This'll work. Trust me.
Sit tight while I take care of business. I'll be back in no time. Nemro will be healthy as a rancor in a meat factory. Or my name isn't Doc.
Jedi standards must be slipping if a worm like Doc qualifies as an ally.
Doc has saved my life many times. He's my friend.
Jedi need him to stay alive. No wonder you people are losing the war. Anyway, that's enough polite chit-chat. Is there anything interesting to eat on this rust bucket? I'm famished.
I did it!
Nemro's gonna live. The disease is cured. He's already regenerated lost tissue and organs.
Wonderful news. I can leave. It's been amusing.
You're not gonna stay and help us celebrate?
Ha! No.
You did a great thing today. You cured an incurable disease. Saved a life.
Even better, I saved someone famous. That's the kind of story the Journal of Xenomedicine loves. I couldn't have done it without you. I'm putting your name in the special thanks section of my article. At the top, even.
This is the worst day of my life. Some idiot bounty hunter killed Nemro the Hutt before the Journal of Xenomedicine could examine him. They can't verify my treatment worked because Nemro's a big messy puddle of goo. There's no proof I saved him.
Someone murdered Nemro? It's awful news.
Yeah, you're telling me? I staked my whole career on him. My only hope is someone else coming down with the disease so I can cure it again. I'm not holding my breath. The disease is rare. It could be years, decades before I get another shot at it.
I know how your mind works. Don't even think about infecting someone with that terrible disease.
I'm not a monster. It would be a mild strain. You know what? The Journal of Xenomedicine can take a flying leap into a black hole. You know, I'm starting my own blasted journal. I've had enough medical adventures these past few years to fill a library. And I'm telling people all about them.
Good. Your knowledge will make the galaxy a better place.
And if I get moderately famous in the process, that's all right too. Publishing a HoloNet journal won't be easy. I'm gonna need recorders, edit droids, and a good S-thread broadcaster. That's some serious scratch. I'll have to start charging for my services. You understand.
Why don't we rob an Imperial bank for the money?
This is why I keep you around. You say what I'm thinking.
Master, I've landed on Corellia. From what I saw flying in, the fighting here is intense.
Corellia is in a state of total war. The Republic and Empire aren't holding back anything. The losses are staggering, and not just military. Thousands of civilians die every hour.
And each death brings the Emperor closer to his goal.
Which is why we cannot retreat. If the Republic pulls back, the Empire will exterminate every being here.
Our enemy doesn't need a planet-destroying device. The war itself will deliver what he needs.
Master Tal Braga is aiding the enemy. He knows how to hurt us, block our efforts to save this world. Removing Master Braga from the Emperor's control is the key to victory.
It's a big world. He could be anywhere.
He commands legions of Imperials and Sith. He cannot do that from hiding. Only a handful of Jedi remain alive on Corellia. I'm sending reinforcements from the Outer Rim, but they're inexperienced. We need strong leadership to win this battle. I'm naming you Supreme Commander of Jedi Forces on Corellia.
I'll resolve this crisis with as few casualties as possible.
Corellia must not fall. Your mission is twofold. Direct our forces to aid the Republic military's efforts, and personally find Master Braga. Until reinforcements arrive, rally those few Jedi already on the surface. My contact, Captain Rickdean, will help you locate them. I'm sending his coordinates. May the Force be with you.
I want those shield generators online yesterday. Move it, privates!
Captain Rickdean, Master Satil Shan sent me. I'm the new Jedi commander.
You made it. Thank the skies. The Empire controls so much of Corellia we could barely establish a landing zone. The enemy has us under constant bombardment. We're in a blasted bottleneck.
Sounds like our first order of business is knocking a hole in the Empire's forward lines.
You'll want to speak with Corporal Hartkey about that. My job is to organize your forces. The shuttles bringing your reinforcements will arrive shortly. In the meantime, you should gather the few already here. I have coordinates to the last known locations of your fellow Jedi. That's the best I can offer.
You've done well. I'll take it from here.
This location is the rallying point for your forces. As the reinforcements arrive, they'll come here. Take the intel on the Jedi you're looking for. I hope you find them.
Asda wohota hagwa topi. Watuma robota donwi wanti wakoba jakamuka. Waduana ubikili watabunka tokapatonga lurda.
I get the feeling we've met before.
Jeska koli raka kanchanga. Bomba kumchinka. Mokilim konki ne ata bomba po shunda. Nera disa sle mo crispa. Vakanki kong kikopa.
I need your mind in the here and now. There's a war to win.
Shopa kisi no ya picha.
I'm taking charge of all Jedi forces. We're rallying reinforcements at these coordinates. Go.
Obedient to the point of self-sacrifice. Good.
It's Corellia. I'm sure there's another cantina somewhere. The Jedi Council appointed me Supreme Commander here. Jedi reinforcements are gathering at these coordinates. On your way.
He's an excellent candidate for shock troop duty.
Is hoge sohanem kert visa. Sezemeles nehes volt felis merni.
All of Corellia is in danger. We need to stop the Empire.
As igas gatto umpa volta capi.
All Jedi forces serve under me. Reinforcements are gathering at these coordinates. Go and wait for my return.
Latlan felit gegob es elenga at ege fat iol zero es sugarzo.
That is what the Emperor hopes.
Sata atenger altala it.
Thank you, my friend. Those assassins were highly persistent. Before they attacked, the Sith showed me a hollow of Master Braga. He ordered them to kill me.
Master Braga is a puppet. The Emperor was trying to demoralize you.
Seeing our most peace-loving master speaking with such hatred was horrifying.
Master Satil appointed me Supreme Commander of Jedi Forces here. You should meet our reinforcements at these coordinates.
I fear I'm not much of a soldier. I've never truly recovered from what happened on Tatooine. I've barely managed to survive so far. Perhaps my talents are better applied elsewhere.
This battle will not be won without sacrifices.
I could focus on evacuating the wounded to the medical transports.
We're facing the total destruction of Corellia. Only the combined forces of every Jedi on this world can stop that.
I'll serve you to the best of my abilities. May the Force be with us. I'll see you at the rendezvous.
All Jedi reinforcements are present and accounted for. General Var Suthra is requesting you on a priority channel. Patching him through now.
Hello, my old friend. I understand you're Supreme Commander of the Jedi Forces here.
There's a Jedi Master helping the Empire destroy Corellia. I need to find him.
Master Satil has asked me to assist your mission however I can. I'm placing my resources at your disposal. I have a base camp in Labor Valley. Bring your people to my position.
You go on ahead. I will guide our forces there.
I'll see you soon, my friend. Varasuthra, out.
General, my forces are on the way.
Glad to hear it. An agent with SIS is bringing us the latest intel on Master Tal Braga. In the meantime, we should form a battle plan to drive the Empire from this sector. It's running riot here. Magrem Thrakis is one of the chief suppliers of the Republic's war effort. She owns half the facilities in Labor Valley.
The Empire appropriated my weapon factories. They're stealing billions of credits worth of firepower.
Should be easy to defend a munitions plant from hostile takeover. Everything you need is there.
I manufacture weapons, not soldiers.
I recommend devoting all Jedi forces to removing the enemy from those weapon factories. We certainly need munitions more than the Empire. It's a priority signal from the Supreme Chancellor. Excuse me.
There is more to this than weapons, you know. The Empire also seized my company's base of operations. I want it back. If you were to allocate forces towards liberating my corporate offices, I'd be extremely grateful. And I do mean personally.
Why would the Empire raid your corporate offices?
I've never trusted Corellia's banking system. I convert all my company's monetary reserves into precious resources. Many are hidden beneath the offices. The Empire hasn't found my resources yet, but given enough time, they will. There's no telling what they could do with all that wealth. I run a multi-trillion credit corporation. If you help me, you won't be disappointed with your reward. Everyone is here and ready to face the enemy on your command. May the Force be with us.
Master Kwix, I haven't seen you since Coruscant. That's an impressive bunch you've brought. If we're going to retake those weapon factories, your people need to go now.
I want those weapon factories cleared of all Imperial forces. Don't let the enemy escape with any munitions.
I will communicate your orders to the others.
General Varasuthra, we've learned the Jedi traitor Tal Braga has sent a strike team to destroy Labor Valley.
If I can get to Master Braga, I'll end these threats for good. Where is he?
We're tracing his holo messages, but there's too much chaos on the comm frequencies to get his location. The Sith have invaded a chemical refinery to create an improvised bomb. The explosion will release a massive toxic cloud. That cloud will kill everyone here and drift into the adjacent sectors, potentially millions of fatalities.
A weapon that indiscriminately kills friend and foe alike. Sith are on a suicide mission.
I'd rather put them out of our misery personally. How do we do that?
We still don't know which chemical refinery the Sith have, but we do know which chemicals they're gathering. Shutting down all the chemical pipelines feeding the refineries won't stop the Sith. However, it will give away their location.
Contact me when it's done. May the Force be with you all.
General, I've shut down the chemical pipelines.
Stand by. Agent Helver is collating the data. Did you run into much trouble out there?
Toxic smoke, killer droids, enemy patrols, the usual.
Is it me, or have you grown a sense of humor? Hang on, we're getting something. One of the chemical plants was siphoning accelerite. We found our Sith bomb makers. I'm sending the coordinates to you and your strike team now. They'll meet you inside. Hurry!
I'll get us through this door. Hang on.
Check your six!
General, the chemical plant is ours. The Sith never finished their bomb.
After all our time together, I never expected anything less. Your Jedi Army sent the Empire packing. Every weapon factory in the sector is now ours, and we're turning those munitions against the enemy. Even better, there were no casualties among your people. It's a rock-solid victory.
Our goal was to kick the Empire out of Labor Valley completely. Can you do it or not, General?
The head start your Jedi gave us? Absolutely. Don't expect overnight results, though. Republic forces have just engaged the Empire in the Axial Park sector. The fighting is heavy, and SIS reports plenty of Sith activity.
Large battles require strong leaders. There's a good chance your target's there.
I already have people in Axial Park at these coordinates. I'll alert the other Jedi to meet you there. Varsuthra, out.
Congratulations. You saved all my weapon factories, at the expense of my company's assets. The Empire stole all our precious resources. My company lost billions to those scum. Farewell, Jedi.
Italian, welcome to
Corellia.
There shouldn't be any argument. The Republic is here to save the people of Corellia. Period.
We're here to win a war, Senator. What good is saving lives if we lose the blasted planet?
There will always be casualties in war. We have to pick our targets carefully.
The Jedi Supreme Commander understands what's at stake much better than you.
Topipuna puna.
Empire sent extermination patrols to our medical evacuation sites. Those murdering scum slaughtered our wounded. Now the Empire's rewarding the killers with parties and medals. They're celebrating in plain sight, taunting us before they're shipped back home. We need to strike back before that filth leaves Corellia. Put some fear in the Empire.
I won't make any decisions without hearing the Senator's request.
Thousands of Corellian citizens are being kidnapped and forced to serve the Empire. We have to free them.
Those citizens are being kidnapped from your prisons. They're criminals.
No. They're in custody awaiting trial. They are innocent until proven guilty, and we cannot abandon them to the enemy.
There's a reason they're locked up. Why should I care what happens to them?
Many were simply in the wrong place at the wrong time. If not for this war, they might have been released already.
Supreme Commander, we've received advanced combat gear from Balmora. If you commit men to my cause, we'll equip you to better face the enemy.
That's outrageous. You're attempting to bribe this Jedi.
That is insulting and incorrect, Senator. I'm adding to the Supreme Commander's knowledge. He'll make the final call.
I was already planning to commit all my forces to your mission, Colonel, but I accept your offer.
I can't believe you! I'm filing a complaint to the Supreme Chancellor.
I have coordinates to the Imperial camps where the extermination squads are celebrating. Let's shut those parties down. Wish I could get surveillance holos to record this. It'd boost morale. Our science advisor is waiting for you. He has information on that rogue Jedi you're after.
Haven't seen you since Darth Angrel became a cloud of random molecules. Glad you joined the festivities. This gathering is long overdue.
This isn't a celebration. People are dying out there, Doctor.
As long as it's the right people dying, that's not a problem for me. My probe droids have been hunting for your Master Braga. They've found enemy activity in two buildings bordering Axial Park. Teams of Sith under Master Braga's command are setting up turbo lasers in the building's topmost floors. They're camouflaging the weapons from view.
Is Master Braga personally overseeing this operation? Can I get to him?
The Sith are only taking orders via Holo, but I'm closing in on the source of those transmissions. Turbo lasers are codenamed Firestorm, an adaptation of the technology from Darth Angrel's superweapon, lethal and focused. Those turbo lasers will make Axial Park a literal inferno. There would be no survivors.
I doubt the enemy soldiers on the ground have been notified of this plan by their Sith masters.
Seems the Empire's left claw doesn't know what the right claw is doing. General Varsuthra wants those turbo lasers destroyed. As I'm currently standing in the line of fire, I'm inclined to agree. Demolitions and transport have been secured. All we need is a small commando group. I'm told you can provide that.
Just point us at the targets.
Republic military transports can't get off the ground here, but there's an Imperial assault shuttle on display at a starship museum nearby. The enemy doesn't know the Corellians have it. They'll mistake the assault shuttle for one of their own. You'll fly directly to your targets.
Impressive plan, Doctor. Let's put it into action.
One last thing. I've modified some proton torpedoes into explosive charges. Drop one down a turbo laser's barrel, and you'll fuse it shut. Weapon neutralized. Get to the shuttle. Stop the Sith before they turn this park into a giant cookout. Good luck.
I need to know something. Do you think you're making a difference?
You had more courage as a Jedi. Enough talking. Come out and face me.
This isn't another of your pointless duels. I don't have time to fight you. None of your victories matter. You're a desperate insect clinging to a burning leaf. In the end, the Emperor wins. This fallen galaxy will be consumed. Purity will be restored.
It isn't the galaxy that's fallen. It's you.
My eyes are open. My hand is guided by truth. One way or another, Corellia dies in flames, and we will all burn together.
Reasoning with him isn't an option. Time for Plan B. I recommend we rendezvous at the Science Museum and see if Dr. Godera can help us find him.
Dr. Godera, the Sith killed him. Damn them!
The Doctor was a brilliant man. He served the Republic with loyalty and dedication. I didn't know him well, but I think he'd rather we keep fighting than stop to mourn him.
I wish the people who believe we can make peace with the Empire could see this.
All enemies accounted for, General. I found Dr. Godera's work. Looks important.
He was tracking Master Braga's holotransmissions. He found signals coming from an Imperial battlecruiser hovering above Capitol Square.
Why would the Empire bring a warship down to the planet's surface?
We assumed it was to intimidate us. Maybe it's something worse. Republic troops established a small forward base in the government district. Gather your people and meet me there.
Your Jedi troops caught the Imperials off guard. Wiped out every one of those murdering scum. You lost a squad in the battle, but they went down fighting. Their sacrifice meant something. Thanks for doing the right thing. I found you some top-of-the-line advanced combat gear.
I'll put this gear to good use. I better get going.
Kick those Imperials into the nearest sun, Supreme Commander. I'll transmit the coordinates of our forward base to all your people and have them meet you there. Good luck!
We're at the point of no return, my friend. Win or lose, this is where we'll make our stand. Eris Wyom is with Corellian Intelligence. He's just learned our job here is even harder than we thought.
My reconnaissance teams just picked up an energy surge coming from the reactors on that Imperial battlecruiser. We believe the cruiser's reactors are being overloaded, building to detonation.
Master Braga sabotaged his battlecruiser. He's using it to destroy this whole sector.
Why not simply crash it into the surface?
A reactor detonation at its present altitude won't just flatten this sector. The radiation release will kill people for hundreds of kilometers. Good news is there's a secure turbo lift connecting the cruiser to the government buildings. They use it to send troops there.
Your strike team will use that to get inside the cruiser, shut down those reactors, and deal with Master Braga.
Can't wait to see their faces when I arrive with all my friends.
Can't take the enemy by surprise with an army of Jedi. But don't worry, your people will have plenty to do. I'm commanding a platoon of Republic troops, with your Jedi squads backing us. We'll hit enemy command and control centers all over this area. We'll keep the enemy's attention off your strike team and retake Capitol Square for the Republic.
I wish there were more Jedi for this mission. It would improve your odds of success.
My people are battle-hardened and ready for anything.
I'm counting on that. This is it, friends. May the Force be with us.
Victory or death for the Republic!
You slipped past the ray shield. That's unfortunate, but you won't win. For the Emperor to succeed, the people of Corellia must die. Only then can this ruined galaxy be redeemed.
The Emperor has filled your head with lies. Death is not redemption. You know better.
There is no redemption through peace. The Emperor showed me the truth. This galaxy isn't worth saving. Every being, every creature is weak and useless. All except him. The Emperor is strong, perfect, transcending both Sith and Jedi. He will cleanse the stars of our impurity.
Then, to follow your logic, I can redeem a fallen Jedi by killing him. Master Braga, prepare for your redemption. Suthra, I've shut down the cruiser's reactors. I repeat, the battlecruiser is under my control.
Understood. I'll send troops to secure the vessel and hold it for the Republic. Fighting down here is bad. I may not be able to...
Do you really think you've won? You only prolong the galaxy's suffering. In the end, no one is saved. This battle will be fought forever. Nothing I do matters.
You'd never faced failure until you met the Emperor. That's what broke you.
I was certain the light would triumph over dark. But he's more than dark. He's a void. You've stopped his plans for now. But the Emperor is patient. He will try again and again until he wins.
It's true. We will never be safe until he's dead.
The Emperor is on Droman Kass. Go to him. You will see how pointless our struggles have been.
Why would I accept such an offer from a man who just tried to kill me?
Face him or don't. It doesn't matter. I will give you the Emperor's coordinates. Even in his weakened state, you are no match for him. I tire of this horrible existence. My life has been a failure. End it.
Let go of your past, Master Braga. If you hate what you are, Become someone better. I know you still care about this galaxy. Do something to make it a worthy place. Go to Tython, rejoin the Jedi Order. It needs you.
You're so confident. I remember that feeling. The sense of purpose. Was it only a dream? Perhaps it's not too late. Maybe you can defeat him and save us all. I'll go to Tython. I'll hope. May the Force be with you.
Let me get this straight. Not only did you save millions of lives, but you and your strike team seized an Imperial battle cruiser? Doesn't sound any less incredible when I say it out loud. The rogue Jedi you were after. Did you catch him?
Master Braga is no longer under the Emperor's control. He's returning to Tython.
Not sure how I feel about him going free. At least he isn't our problem anymore. I wish I had good news. But the General's mission was not successful. He didn't have the forces he needed. They put up a good fight, but the enemy had superior numbers. There were no survivors.
It could have been worse. We could all be dead.
I suppose when you look at it that way. There's still plenty of fighting to be done. The Empire is down, but it's already regrouping. I'd ask you to stay, but I get the feeling you've already got one foot out the door. Good luck.